felt it. I tried to beat you, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest. And nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. Just to try to see it clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanities and just go with the seasons. It's what we aim to do. Our name is our virtue. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you find that the sky is yours. So please don't, please don't, please don't. There's no need here to complicate, 'cause our time is short. This, oh, this, oh, this is our fate.
Thank you. Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice. Cause I speak of the pompous of love. People talk about me, baby. Say I'm doing you wrong, doing you wrong. Well, don't you worry, baby, don't worry. Cause I'm right here, right here, right here, right here at home. Cause I'm a picker, I'm a grinner, I'm a lover, and I'm a sinner. I play my music in the sun. I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. I sure don't want to hurt no one. I'm a picker, I'm a grinner, I'm a lover, and I'm a sinner. I play my music in the sun. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. My loving on the run. Ooh.
took my love, took it down. I climbed a mountain and I turned around, and I saw my reflection in snow-covered hills till the landslide brought me down. Oh, mirror in the sky, what is love? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I sail through the changing ocean tides? Can I handle the seasons of my
rocket man, burning out his fuse out of pain. pile of place to raise your kids. In fact, it's cold as hell, and there's no one there to raise them. If you did, and all the science I don't understand, it's just my job 5 days.
And let's stand. my first real six string. Bought it at the five and dime. Played it till my fingers bled. Was a summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried.
tell you to run.
On my way, on my way.
Mobody say, mobody on.
About me. piano singing his song. All the little birds on Jay Bird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet. Rockin' Robin,
tweet, tweet, tweet,
rock, rock, rockin' Robin,
tweet, tweet,
blow, rockin' Robin, cause we really gonna rock tonight.
Tweet, tweet, tweet,
every little swallow, every chickadee, every little bird in the tall oak tree, the wise old owl, the big black crow, flap for their wings, sing and go, bird, go. Rockin' Robin,
tweet, tweet, rock, rock, tweet,
rockin' Robin,
tweet,
rockin' Robin, cause we're really gonna rock tonight.
Tweet,
blow,
tweet, tweet.
A pretty little raven at the birdman stand talked him out to do the bump and it was grand. He started going steady and bless my soul, pop the buzzard and the Oreo. He rocks in the treetop all day long, popping and a popping and a singing his song. All the little birds on Jay Bird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet. Rockin' Robin,
tweet, tweet, rock,
rock, rockin' Robin,
tweet, tweet,
blow, rockin' Robin, cause we're really gonna rock tonight.
Tweet,
tweet, we own the pretty little raven at the birdman stand. Taught him how to do the pop and it was grand. They started going steady and bless my soul, he out-popped the buzzard and the Oreo. He rocks in the treetop all day long, hopping and a-bopping and a-singing his song. All the little birds on Jay Bird Street talk to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet. Rockin' Robin,
tweet, tweet,
rock, rock, rockin' Robin,
tweet,
blow, rockin' Robin, cause we're really gonna rock tonight.
Recording software, so I'm not really familiar with this one yet, so bear with me if there's any technical difficulties. So I just want to go over some, actually two setups of which I am currently focusing on in my trading, and that is the Bounce Short from Dux's DVD, Steven Dux, and also the Overextended Gap Down. Those are the two setups I'm trading right currently, but I have no positions right now. Also, I'm studying the gap up short. So, first thing I want to do is go over the bounce short setup and my morning watch list today. Here's AEZS. I've been stalking this for a few days, waiting for it to have some sort of excessive spiking into a resistance level on the 2-year chart, because that resistance level has volume, this volume right here. So first I'm going to explain the bounce short setup, and what it is you have to look for sort of a run-up day with excessive spiking, and the volume has to be significantly higher than its previous trading volume. And the reason for this is more people are trading it during this time right here, so this resistance level is more likely to hold as a resistance. due to all the bag holders that are in from these levels. So how you figure that out is we zoom in here first and you see that this day had 61.4 million volume. You can see it right here. The volume changes when I highlight the candle. 61.4 million volume right there. And it topped out at 2.8. You can see the high over here. This day, 48.5 million volume, and it topped at 329. So our areas of interest right off the bat are going to be 2.8 and 3.29 because these high volume traded days topped out at those levels, making it significantly higher odds for shorting. So one thing is, when you're seeing this, and it's pre-market, so it'll still be down here, it's kind of
So, cigarettes and gas, $79.70.
Crap.
There's an ATM right outside.
Yeah, I don't have a card.
Well, you can write a personal check with ID.
Kinda in between banks right now. You think I should just come back later? I'm totally good for it. I'd come back, I swear.
If it were me, I'd be totally, you know, no problem. But my dad is this ginormous hard ass. He was in Fallujah for a year, and he always checks the receipts. I mean, like, always. I gotta call him. I'm sorry.
Wait. Hold on a second. Maybe we could, trade. Ever try it?
I mean, I smoke pot a lot sometimes. I party. But that stuff's really addictive, right?
Not really. It's just a media thing. You know?
What's it like?
It's awesome. Everything's maximum interesting. You get these really cold and sharp, like, action dagger feelings. It's awesome. Come on. What do you say?
So how does it feel? Does it hurt?
Yeah, it's tight.
Yeah, but is it painful?
It's hard to breathe.
We need you breathing. Although, let's not lose sight of the fact that you were the victim of a terrible accident, Antonio, so some discomfort is to be expected. Let's go with that one. Mucho gusto en conocerla, señora. La próxima vez, cashier's check. Por favor. Oh, and spread the word. I'm building a class action, Flight 515. Victims' families would be great, but I'll take anyone on the ground who suffered emotionally, anxiety, sleeplessness. You get the picture. Trouble?
Ted Beneke, you cannot be serious. That guy is a joke. I called you. What does that even mean?
You dared me to tell the police, and I couldn't do it, so you win.
Oh,
if you want to stay in this house, fine, but we are not married.
God, I told you that I was done cooking that, Skylar. I promised you that.
What?
You know, at least I didn't have to go. Jesus, I mean, everything that I did for this family.
Yeah, you just keep telling yourself.
Oh, and what is that supposed to mean?
You don't like it? Then leave and take your drug money
with
you.
That's what you want.
Jesus. Garbage disposal.
You think this will get me to move out? You can screw Ted. You can screw the butcher, the mailman, whoever you want. Screw them all. I'm not going anywhere.
Suit yourself.
The
Is this a good or a bad thing?
Suit myself. You want me to suit myself? I'll suit myself to his face!
It's a bad thing.
Hello. Walter White to see Ted Beneke.
I'm sorry, Mr. Beneke's on a conference call.
Okay. I will wait.
It could be a while.
I have all the time in the world. Okay.
Excuse me, Mr. Beneke's not available.
Ted? Come on.
Sir, excuse me. Excuse me.
Ted, I can see you. I can see you standing right there in your office. Now, come on. Open the door. Come on, let's talk. I just want to talk, that's all. Come on, let's be men about this, huh? Okay? How about that? Aha!
Hey, Walt, I'm kind of in the middle of something right now.
Oh, yes, you are.
So open the door.
You're damn right you are. You're right in the middle. Just open the door and let's talk about it, okay? Open the door, Ted, right now. All right, you don't want to be a man about it? Okay, plan B. How do you like that? Plan B.
We have a situation in this. Walt. 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 What are you doing?
I'm talking with Ted.
Next time, you'll open the door. There he is. Come on.
Damn it.
Oh, what? What? No, I just want to talk. I just want to talk.
Oh, man. Let's go.
God. I just talk. I just want to talk to him.
Calm down. Just talk. Okay, all right. All right, all right, all right. I'm calm. I'm calm.
Wrong with you? You act like you're the first guy this ever happened to. I caught my second wife screwing my stepdad, okay? It's a cruel world, Walt. Grow up.
I just wanted to talk to him.
Yeah, well, now I'm talking to you, okay? Consider this an intervention. You could have been arrested back there, you understand. I mean, speaking as your lawyer, I'm always looking for billable hours. But speaking as your business associate, I'm strongly advising that you get your shit together. Cool it with this Beneke guy, at least for now, okay? Let's talk shop. Because I think this is a great opportunity to channel some of that negative energy into something positive.
How did you know?
Sorry?
About Skyler, about where to find me just now. How did you know?
That's just my meticulousness. Don't bog down in detail, Walt. The lesson here...
Did you bug my house?
Yeah, but I didn't know it was your house, did I? You'd moved out. Besides, you basically told me to.
I told you to?
You strongly hinted that I should. You were worried about your wife, remember? You were concerned she might say something to the police.
What? No, that's not true. When the hell did I say that?
Let's not get lost in the who, what, and whens. The point is, we did our due diligence, and she didn't talk. She kept quiet. She stood by you, Walt, which... if you ask me, is the ironical silver lining here. I mean, on the one hand, sure, she snuck off the reservation to get some dirty, damp, and deep. On the other hand... good! Oh, boo-hoo, I won't cook meth anymore. You're a crybaby. Who needs you? Hey, I'm unplugging the website, so no more money laundering. How do you like that?
I want those bugs out of my house today. I want them out now!
Oh, you just bought a $300 suit, psycho!
Great. Drilled right into the stucco.
Oh, a little bit of putty. You'll be fine.
Just make sure you get all of those things.
A, these things cost $800 a piece. B, you're not that interesting. So yeah, I'll get all of them, Walter.
Great line of work, by the way. Real upstanding field.
Yeah, well, I enjoy it.
You're free to leave now. Anytime.
You know, Walter, sometimes it doesn't hurt to have someone watching your back.
I can't begin to understand what you're going through, Walt, with all of your health concerns and the stresses you've been under. Still, as educators, there are certain responsibilities we need to be meeting here, to the school and to the students themselves.
Of course. Is this a Wheaton Terrier?
Norfolk.
Norfolk? That's surprising.
Walt, could you come back over here and have a seat, please?
Sure.
You've been absent a lot recently. Mm-hmm. And when you are here at school, there have been some behavioral questions. And frankly, I'm concerned.
Thank you.
Are you feeling okay? Do you think maybe I should call Skylar?
Let's just keep this. Let's handle this on our own.
Well, hey! Walt, what's wrong with you?
You know, look, you're the one always talking about DC, okay? This is how you get there. You answer the bell, you pay your dues. Besides, it's a big deal to get picked for this. El Paso is like the Super Bowl. I could get killed crossing the street, okay? Whatever, you know, I want to go.
What about last time?
What about last time?
Schrader. Hey, Sheriff. Blue, huh? Yeah. Thing is, I'm supposed to be getting on a plane right now. The stuff this guy had was blue. You're sure about that? Yeah. Yeah, I want to talk to him.
Stay in touch with their belongings at all times.
Taxi!
Sorry I needed to talk to you, but you weren't at your apartment.
No, I moved back home.
It's good, right?
Yo, did he just get fired?
No. It's
more like a sabbatical.
Indefinite. Yeah. Go somewhere?
No, this is fine.
So, one intro to your guy.
What guy?
Your guy, your distribution guy. The guy Saul hooked you up with.
No. Come on, Jesse.
I thought about it, and I want to. It's one thing I'm good at.
Now that is just not true. You're good at a lot of things, son.
Like what?
What about your sobriety?
I told you I'm not using. Ever. I just want back into the business.
Well, I don't. I'm sorry.
I know, and that's cool. Not asking me to cook.
What's this?
In the end, I just went with two reflux condensers. I didn't want to lose track of my pH levels. But I did everything else just like you taught me. Super careful my amounts and watch the numbers every step of the way. So what do you think? It's good, right?
What in the hell is this?
What?
What? This is my product. This is my formula. This is mine.
Okay, it's our product. But yeah, I was gonna cut you in.
Oh, you were gonna cut me in? No. I cut you in.
No, what the hell's your problem? All I'm asking is for you to set a meet.
Absolutely not.
Why?
I am not going to lend my name to an inferior product. I mean, look at the diameters here. What did you use for a reduction? Don't tell me. Platinum dioxide, right?
No. Mercury aluminum amalgam. The dioxide's too hard to keep wet.
All right, well, you must have done it wrong then. Your color is all cloudy, so you were struggling with distillation too. Now, this is very shoddy work, Pinkman. I'm actually embarrassed for you.
What? No way. I gave out samples and everyone said it was the bomb.
Oh, they said it was the bomb. And who were they, I wonder? Huh? A bunch of meth heads?
Yeah. They should know, right?
Well, sorry. I can't help you.
Fine, asswad. You know what? I'll contact the guy myself.
Oh, yeah? Well, good luck, because my guy is a pro, and he doesn't deal with junkies.
Hey, you know what? Eat me.
Anytime, loser. Oh, hey. Wait. Hey!
It's only 4:00. This day is dragging.
Stay.
What's stopping you?
What? Like everything, you mean? How about my lunatic husband refusing to leave the house?
So we'll move in here.
And then my son hating me even more.
Nah. That'll pass. I went through that with the girls. They adapt.
And now everyone at work thinks I'm an evil letter-climbing whore.
They're all fired, effective immediately. What else?
Oh, aren't you the answer man?
What did it, where'd it go wrong exactly with you and Walt? I mean, I always saw him as kind of mild-mannered. Something, I don't know, changed when he got sick, or...
I don't know what changed, Ted. And I just don't feel really comfortable talking about it.
Stop it. Just asking out of self-interest. Gotta make sure I don't make the same mistake.
I would be amazed.
So let me see if I'm following here, Russell. You got this stuff from some guy at Gasparza's who was wearing tan pants and who you're 80% sure had a mustache. That's it, right? That's your brain working at maximum capacity.
Russell? Everything all right in there?
Mel. The dude's name was Mel.
Well, there you go. See? You served an actual earthly function.
I can't believe I remembered that.
Mel who? Does he have a last name?
Yeah. Mel. Wait. Was it Mel? Or Mark? It was definitely him name. Oh, man. I'm losing it. Wait. Yeah. It's gone.
It's gone.
It was an M name, though. Yeah. I remember the M sound.
Huh? We'll go with the M sound. Thanks a lot.
Yeah. He definitely had tan pants.
Might make it a vasectomy. Okay, it's after 9, so this bar that Girl George is at, probably wall-to-wall dirtbags by now. Let's go have a little looky-loo. See if we can't find this M-named clown.
What?
To lead.
Lead to what?
To Heisenberg. I told you it was only a matter of time before this guy booted up again. Here we go, my friend. Don't hate me because I'm beautiful, Gomi. Just apologize and buy me a beer.
And you're reaching. This stuff could be a knockoff or leftover from an older cook. How do you know Heisenberg's gearing up again?
How do I know? Because I know.
I don't get it. This is the reason why you're blowing off the task force? Chase down teeners?
I'm getting tired of all this second guessing. If you're not sufficiently stimulated by this investigation, do us both a favor and ask for transfer.
What is up with you lately? Starting bar fights? Turning down El Paso? And now this bullshit? Do you need to talk to someone or what?
Talk to someone? Talk to who?
I'm not trying to step on your toes, bro, okay? Just worried about you. That's all.
Appreciate that. Bro, take your hand off my shoulder.
Yeah, the one that was on TV. Did any little piece fall on your property? I'm not looking for an entire wing here, Mr. Linkus. It could be a nut or a bolt. It could be a bag of peanuts, just so long as it caused you pain and suffering. Oh, no. Closed. Calling you back. You had your chance. I told you to get him cooking again, and you blew it off, and now it's too late. The guy's gone mass maniac on us. All I wanted was to show you two your potential, and what do I get in return? A bone contusion. You want to see the scar? I wish you to.
Hi there. How in the hell did you get Walt?
I made it. You know the guy who knows the guy, right?
Good news is, for a stage 3 cancer, the guy's doing well, physically. Mentally, the guy's a disaster. He's gone off the rails over this thing with his wife. My opinion, he's not coming back, not on his own. Your friends were at his place again, by the way. They drew something on the street outside his house. A scythe.
Does the lawyer know?
Should he?
No.
If you want this guy to produce again, why not just tell him? You're the only thing that stands between him and an axe in the head.
I don't believe fear to be an effective motivator. I want investment. For now, I'm simply interested in time frame. He will live for the foreseeable future, yes.
Foreseeable, couple years at least, barring acts of God and men with axes. Oh. From the lawyer, I'm supposed to let you know the Pinkman kid is looking to sell.
I don't work with junkies.
Well, that's what I thought you'd say. Probably for the best. What I hear, he and Walter are Splitsville.
Really?
That's what Goodman says. Cats and dogs.
Do the deal.
Schrader, you need to be calling me back ASAP. I've got Texas breathing down my neck and I'm not about...
I haven't seen Matt since my dad fired him, like, a while ago.
Where can I find him, you think?
No idea. I haven't seen him.
I know. You said that a few times.
Yeah, because I haven't seen him. I don't know what else to say.
What's your name, darling?
Kara.
Where'd this come from, Kara?
I don't know. What is it? Drugs?
Look, I'm just gonna come right out and say it. You're a bad liar, Kara. Well, don't get me wrong. Not the worst I've ever seen. Once had a guy try to explain the dope balloon up his butt on bad Thai food. Still, you're not a very good liar.
I honestly don't know where you're
Stop. Going. You look like a good kid. I'm not here to get you in trouble, but you need to tell me where this came from right now!
I never do stuff like this, I swear to God. I tried it and I hated it, so I just gave it to Matt.
Okay, and who gave it to you?
Some guy, he came in a couple days ago and wanted to trade it for gas.
Some guy. What's his name? Okay. What do you look like?
I don't know. They looked pretty normal. You know, white. I think his hair was a lightish brown. He had really blue eyes. You know, really, really blue.
Yeah. Dreamy. Okay. What else? Piercings, jewelry, distinctive articles of clothing. Come on. Come on. Listen to me. It's real important that I find the person that had these drugs. So if you can remember anything else, come on. Think. Come on now. Come on.
Drove an RV.
Okay, good. What can you remember? What kind of RV? What color? Did you spot a license plate?
I don't know the kinds. And I didn't see the license. But the color was, I think, white, brownish color. I'm sorry. I know I'm not helping you, but please don't tell my dad.
Kara. Please tell me that that camera works.
These eggs are good, Mom.
Thanks.
Hey, you know what's weird? Dad's website. It's been 3 days since the last donation.
Yeah, well, people lose interest.
So how long are you off for?
Few weeks. I will play it by ear. I probably pushed it, you know, coming back to work too soon.
Think I can get a ride today? Lewis has a doctor's appointment. Hey, so Dad can babysit now, right? You won't have to take Holly to work every day.
Sometime, maybe. Yeah, we'll see.
Enjoy, yo.
Wait. No, no.
No, Ray.
Hey! 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 What the hell? This is only half.
That's right. It's your half.
Yo! Where's the other half, bitch?
Yeah, I mean, it was, the whole thing was crazy. I mean, poor bastard felt sorry for him. I think he actually thought we were the cable guys, you know? Anyway, sorry about those missed calls, Chief. Change of providers and it won't happen again.
Are you going to El Paso, Hank?
Hell yes! With pointy boots and bells on. Just, I got this break in the Heisenberg case.
The blue meth, you mean? The teeth?
Yeah, well, that teeth got things rolling. I traced it to a gas station in Cibola, and that's where I got these. Now, the station's closed circuit was down, surprise, surprise. But I was able to pull off some of these snapshots of an ATM security camera. You know, we always thought these guys might be camper cooking, right? First off, your typical Class C motorhome is gonna grunt at least 5,000 pounds of interior fixtures, okay? We're talking appliances, furniture, built-ins, 5,000 pounds at least, okay? See how high that suspension's riding? No way, no how this thing's carrying that kind of weight. I mean, this thing has been cleared out and stripped down to its tightened curlies. For what? Blood bank? Maybe a bookmobile?
It's no clear view of the plates.
Yeah, well, you can only get so lucky, right? But the fact that there's no front plate tells me it's likely New Mexico registration. I checked with DMV. There are only 29 of these early 80s bounders registered in the state.
Only 29?
Yeah. So I gotta go, knock on some doors.
They need you in El Paso, Hank.
You bet. I'm just going to wrap up this Heisenberg thing first.
So you're refusing the assignment?
No, I'm not. I'll go. It's just I need some more time.
You're not hearing me, Agent Schrader. You're out of time. Are you going to El Paso now? Tonight? It's a simple yes or no.
But that's only because I'm really close to something big here.
Better get to it then.
Albuquerque's News Radio, KECA News Time, 10:13. Our top story this hour, Donald Margolis, the air traffic controller criticized for his role in the recent air disaster in which 167 persons died, was rushed to an area hospital early this morning, apparently the victim of a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Police won't say whether or not...
All I took was just one look, I knew... has just begun. The two of us spending all our days in the valley of the sun.
Your half.
Was just one look. I knew that this was really love. Now my life has just begun.
okay.
The two of us are one, spending all our days in the valley of the sun.
I am awake.
You are not how I remember you from class. I mean, like, not at all. Dude, this isn't even $7,000. All right, my guy wants 85.
This is all the money I have in the world. You are a drug dealer. Negotiate. Buy the RV. We start tomorrow.
Work it, baby. Yo, this is sick, brother.
Totally.
Oh, God.
Yo, Jesse, I got these two fine ladies want to participate. You got the funds?
Oh, I got the funds. Hey, would you ladies like to meet my fat stack? Get in here. Come on. Hey, yo, you got champagne? None of that cheap stuff. I want the expensive shit. Don Perry, Don.
It's $400 a bottle.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll only have two. Oh, and I want the tall, skinny glasses. I like those skinny glasses. That's what James Bond drinks, mofos. I'm all about that.
Yo, Jesse, man, I gotta ask. Where'd you get all the cheddar?
Must be moving mad volume. It's totally funny. You wanna know what's funny?
What's funny?
This old dude, he gave it to me.
What?
He gave it to me. It's like his entire life savings.
What?
Why? Because he's a dumbass, that's why. Yes! Woo! All right, live and large, players.
Scientist, I run the house and sign the tits and that's it. Don't take no astrophysicist to make your ass don't freak now, sisters kick it. My animals like I was rocking on my dynamic knowledge. I'm technotronic, flipping gym and chronic like I'm selfish. I am the killer, shaking off some old rocket and rolling.
Them drum machines ain't got no soul.
Gamo chicks on Discovery Channel. I'm hot like Telemundo chicas on a solar panel. See me on Sesame Street cooling in the culture and tea. I slap you silly like hillbilly chicks on Dave's on TV.
Thank you. Yo, thank you. Thank you.
That was... Awesome, bro. Later.
Oh, God.
Oh, man. Oh, I'm so dead. Oh, my God. Oh, damn.
I only got like 1,400.
Waffle House? Yeah.
No, man. I'm supposed to use that dude's money to buy an RV.
What do you want with an RV for?
Cause like, never mind. Jesus, you know, I gotta like leave town or change my identity or something. Guy's blackmailing me. Got like a criminal mind.
Yo, RV, yeah? I can hook you up, bro. I can totally get you an RV.
No, I need it today.
Now,
no problem. Let's go.
You tell me you can get me an RV. We're 1400 at 6 in the morning. Oh.
Do I need to sign something or something?
Nah, it's like a no paperwork type deal. Pleasure doing business with you. Come on, we gotta bounce.
What?
For real, yo, get it out of here.
This feels fantastic.
Can you control the temperature?
Yeah. There should be a switch right next to you there. It's a thermostat.
Ted, this has got to be the most amazing invention ever.
I know. Contractor talked me into it. Seemed kind of extravagant, but gotta tell you, once you try it, you can't go back.
I can never find anything in this Buick.
You know, you could leave a few things here if you want.
Why don't you go get your dad?
Sure.
Hey, Dad. Dad.
Yeah?
Mom's asking. Wanna come to dinner?
Yeah, I'll be right there.
Listening to me. I don't know.
Yeah, right. Like, you don't know.
What did I just say?
Give me the phone. Give it.
Like, you didn't make some deal behind my back.
Correct. I did not. I was sitting at a stoplight minding my own business when the kid threw a bag of money through my window.
Whatever, man. You owe me that money.
Well, let me talk.
I owe you? I owe you nothing. And I will get to the bottom of this. Trust me.
Trust you. That's a good one. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
You want to talk about trust, Jesse? Let's talk about trust. I told you not to cook my formula, and you went ahead and did it anyway.
Because I never said I want to cook it, because it ain't yours, it's ours. Plural, bitch.
Not have my permission.
All I know is I got half the money I'm due, and you got the rest.
Escalating, you're escalating.
You escalate this. My meth, my money.
I will be a one-man glass factory. I will rock that RV 24-7.